Hi, my name is Alex and welcome to a brand new quick tip by JANUS Engineering. Optimizing toolpaths into drilling can be a real time waster in CAM programming. We often have different bores and predefined toolpaths that are anything but optimal. You can often spring us toolpaths that look something like this, where the toolpaths are wildly confused and the tool jumps around awkwardly from one hole to the next. That brings us to today's quick tip. Siemens NX offers many options for optimizing the toolpaths between different operations. One of them is the optimized NC function. This will create a well-structured and time-saving option for creating toolpaths.
And here we are. As you can see, this part contains a lot of holes in it. Holes usually need to be spot drilled before drilling them. So, for in this case, we have spot drills with diameters 8, 10, H7, M8, M6, and M4. As you can see, we are spot drilling all of these geometries with the same tool, just all separate operations. When we do so, the tool goes to all the diameter 8 first, then the 10, then the 8, then the 6, and so forth. This means that the toolpath will be a bit of a mess. If we select all of these and click, we can see that the result looks something like this. All these paths can cause a lot of waste of time. So how do we optimize them? Well, we'll go in, right-click, insert, program group. When we do so, we are going to select hole making as our type. Once this dialog box opens, we can see that within hole making, there are two options available. There's the generic program group, like every other one has, and then there's also the optimize NC group. We select this one, and then we'll click OK once and then once again. Just like that, we'll have a new program group that is called Optimized NC. We can then select all of the operations that are cutting with that same tool and drop them into this new Optimized NC program group. When we double-click the folder, we can now see that all of the features are listed inside of it. Now, we can go in and we can customize how we want to reorder this list. Using the optimization settings, we can change the settings from the closest to the shortest path, and then reorder our list. And now we can see that the first hole will be here, and then the second one, and then the third one, and they follow the part in the shortest path. When we generate it, we can see that the updated toolpath that is optimized for the shortest toolpath. If you're interested in how to group these feature elements and what the tool axis settings have to do with it, you can click the link in their description. Our colleagues explained how to do it.
Thanks to Siemens NX, we can now combine many operations into one so that we have the most ideal toolpath from one feature to the next. Incidentally, one of our previous NX tutorials demonstrate how to generate a tool in Siemens NX based on a feature. This can also be done to save a lot of time, so be sure to check out that video as well. As always, if you have any NX concerns or issues, please be sure to leave a comment and subscribe to our channel. Maybe you'll be featured in an upcoming quick tip. Until next time,